My name is John Payne, I'm 33, and this is my story. I had always had an active life. My family had a cabin at Pickwick. We spent the summers on the lake water skiing and stuff, and then we spent the winters riding motorcycles. So I got my first motorcycle when I was 5, and that kind of drew my interest into motorcycling and riding bikes as well. Around the age of 14 or 15, a good friend of mine got me into mountain biking. Raced my first race down in Arcabala. Then I raced Tour de Wolf here in town a couple weeks later. Really enjoyed it, so I got a better bike and started getting really active in mountain biking. Raced all through my teenage years up till I was about 18 or 19. Got better and better and advanced up through the various ranks in mountain biking. Towards the end of when I was mountain biking, I was training really extensively. I would get up in the mornings before I would go to school and work out or ride, and I would go to school, work a little bit, and come home and either work out or ride again. I'd become really competitive. I won a Junior Nationals AMBC race in Florida in 97 and was training for Nationals in Vermont in 98. I was racing a lot of smaller regional races. I went to a race in Chattanooga, Tennessee on June 28th. I went up there a day early and rode the trail a couple times just to familiarize myself with the trail. On the day of the race, coming down a hill that I'd ridden two or three times the day before, hit a small stump in the trail, flipped over the handlebars at about 40 miles an hour, and hit a tree and compressed my spine until it broke. I was paralyzed immediately from the chest down. Fortunately, thankful to God, there was a fire rescue woman about 20 yards from the scene. She was immediately on top of me and kept other riders from moving me around or taking anything off and further paralyzing me. They airbagged me to Erlanger Hospital in Chattanooga. I was there for a couple weeks, had surgery, and then was sent to Shepherd Center in Atlanta, Georgia, a phenomenal rehab hospital where I went through rehab. It's about a 6-week process. They teach you everything you possibly need to know when you come out, and they also just encourage you to know that you can do everything you wanted to do or you did prior to your accident. You just do it in a little bit of a different way. I remember meeting with a psychologist the first day I was there, or one of the first days I was there, and I saw a bunch of books in her room that were about sports, and I was still interested in doing sports, so I got all those books and read up on some of the sports I could do, and mainly in cycling because I came from cycling. So when I got home, within about a month, I had a hand cycle. I got it just to stay in shape and have something fun to do. Rode the hand cycle, just not racing or not competitive in any way, just rode it just to have fun. In 2003, some people at work at AutoZone talked me into signing up for St. Jude Half Marathon. I trained mostly in the chair that I'm in every day, and about 3 weeks before the race, somebody actually gave me a racing chair so I could race the race in a racing chair. Had a great time running St. Jude. Decided to sign up for the Germantown Half, ran the Germantown Half, had a great time, and that's kind of where I fell in love with running. Just started running 5Ks, 10Ks, 4-milers, half marathons. Ran my first marathon in 2004 at St. Jude as well, and just was really enjoying running. In the past year, I've gotten a lot faster. Actually started running with Breakaway about a year ago, and then in the past 6 months, Kevin Leathers has really been helping me out a lot. I've managed to PR my 4-miler, my 5K, my half marathon, and my marathon time. PR'd my marathon time about 2 weeks ago at the Huntsville Marathon. PR'd it by over 20 minutes with a 2:22:12. My focus is on getting faster so that I can qualify for Boston someday. That's kind of my long-term goal. The Boston qualifier for the wheelchair is 2 hours flat. If I can wrap this up by just saying, just focus on the positive, don't focus on the negative. When I got paralyzed, obviously I could have focused on the negative of the situation, that I was paralyzed, I couldn't ride my bike anymore. But instead, through help from my family and through help with my church and through help with God, I was able to focus on the positive of the situation, get on with life, get back to doing everything, normal day stuff, just hanging out with friends, making new friends, riding my hand cycle, and then eventually getting into running. And running has really been great. I've made a lot of good friends in the running community, serving on the board, serving on the St. Jude committee, and also just hanging out at Breakaway on Wednesday night runs and Thursday night runs and just having a good time. So I would just encourage everybody, focus on the positive, don't focus on the negative, and just try to make the best out of every situation in your life.